Here's some terminology we need to go ahead and cover real quick. An IP address, or Internet Protocol address, is an address used to redirect packets from one host to another. A packet is a piece of data assembled to be sent over a network. A host is someone who is receiving or sending an item over the network. The fundamental thing to understand about communication is sending something from one place to another. The simplest way to explain this is a source, the encoder, the transmitter, the medium, the receiver, the decoder, and then the destination. Whenever things are sent over the network, they use protocols. Protocols have a fundamental to dictate how they work, and there are five factors to how a protocol works. The first factor is message encoding, which is how the message is encoded for transmission. The second factor is message formatting and encapsulation, which is how the message is prepared to be sent. The third factor is message size. Whenever things are sent, the protocol needs to determine how the message is fragmented. The fourth factor is message timing. There are things like when someone can send a message, how to determine the timing, and the response timeout whenever there is no response. The entirety of the internet is made up of autonomous systems. Here are some protocols that support these systems. In networking, one of the most important models to learn from the beginning is the Internet Protocol Suite and the OSI model. These give you an idea of how each protocol works with each other to allow communication. Protocols that exist can be separated into different categories. Here are some examples. In the network access layer, Ethernet defines a physical medium for connecting networks. In the Internet layer, Internet Protocol, or IP, prepares and receives messages made for end-to-end communication over networks. In the transport layer, Transmission Control Protocol, or TCP, is used for reliable transmission of messages. In the application layer, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, or HTTP, is the standard for communication for things around the web. The Open Systems Intercommunication model is used to lay down the grounds for network communication to work. Another similar model is the TCP/IP model. These models share the layers that I'm going to inform you about. The physical layer is anything mechanical or electrical that helps with the transmission. Protocols that fall under here include things like point-to-point protocol and Ethernet. The data link layer is the exchange of data frames between devices over common media using physical addresses. In the TCP/IP model, the physical layer and the data link layer are combined into one layer called the network access layer. The network layer is where the data is exchanged over the networks. This includes protocols like IPv4, IPv6, and ICMP. In the TCP/IP model, this layer is the internet layer. The transport layer is used to fragment, transfer, and assemble data between hosts. This layer includes protocols like TCP and UDP. In the TCP/IP model, this layer is the transport layer. The session layer keeps sessions alive and works with data exchange. The presentation layer handles incoming encoded data and decodes it. The application layer is where end users interact. The session, presentation, and application layer deal with protocols like HTTP, DNS, DHCP, and FTP. In the TCP/IP model, they're all combined into the application layer. Data needs to be segmented into packets. Large, uninterrupted streams of data would prevent communication, as every piece of data is sent one piece at a time. Having smaller pieces of data being sent at their own pace is called multiplexing and allows multiple hosts to send their data. There are these things called PDUs within these protocols that we're talking about, which are pieces of information that go hand in hand with certain layers. In the transport layer, the PDU is a segment or datagram. Depending on which PDU you get, it determines if it's a TCP or UDP packet. On a network, the PDU is a packet that has a source IP address and a destination IP address. On the data link layer, the PDU is the frame, which has the source and MAC address, which are responsible for local delivery via MAC addresses. That wraps it up for this episode on networking and communication. Being able to visualize and learn how things work helps you understand the fundamentals of networking. In the next Crash Course, we're going to be taking a look at IP addressing. For now, I'll see you in the next episode.
We'll be right back.